Hey guys and girls, I've got another headset review for you today. Now, I ordered this headset, which is the Sades SA905 in white, about 5 weeks ago. I was looking for a headset that had vibration feature and to basically replace my Koshin HG2200s, which the microphone fell off. And these were advertised as a vibrating headset on eBay, and they were about $27, around that price mark. So I thought, why not, give it a go. Now, I am going to mention the bad things first, because, guys, there are a few. They're niggly, but they are pretty... they're worth mentioning, straight up. Because then you guys have to wait for the good stuff. Okay, let's get the bad stuff out of the way first. First bad thing is there's no inline controller on the on the headphone line. It's all on the back of the ear cup, and you only get a volume control and a vibration button. That's it. There is no mic mute, so you can't mute the microphone if you need to take a phone call during a gaming session. The only option you've got is to actually mute the microphone through your computer settings. The other thing is that it does have a volume control on the back of the headset, but it only operates the headset only, not your computer's sound card. Okay, I would have thought being a USB-only headset that the controller would be interfaced into the sound card, but no, it only adjusts the headset itself. The other thing is they're a pretty loose fit. It has this adjustable elastic band thing. And if you've got a small head, then this headset is definitely not for you. Okay, the other niggly little thing is the LEDs don't show the same color at the same time. They show different colors at random. I think there's 7 colors in each LED ear cup, but at the moment, as you can see, they don't show the same color at the same time. As I said, it's a niggly complaint. Now let's get on to the other thing is, they're quiet. They may be quiet due to the fact that Sades have put in a volume limiting factor into it. So they're not as loud as, say, a pair of HG2200s. They're actually relatively quiet. But let's get on to the good things. One good thing about this headset is they sound good. They've got nice highs, good mid-range, and decent lows. Not overly bassy, but decent lows. The vibration function has 3 steps. There's off, weak, and strong. And on strong, the headset really does jiggle quite good. So if you're playing a first-person shooter game or bass-heavy music, you are going to experience the headset jiggle. It's pretty cool. The other thing I will say about this headset is it's comfy. They are comfy. The ear cups feel really good. Even though it's a loose fit, they do sit on my head just fine. But if you do have a smaller head, they may fall off. The other thing is that vibration button on the back of the ear cup can also turn off the LEDs. All you got to do is push and hold, and they turn off. So if you don't like the LEDs annoying you at night, you can turn them off. And to turn it back on, you just push and hold that vibration button again, and there you go. So the vibration button also controls the LEDs. Now, what I'm going to do for you guys is I'm going to stop the video here, and I'm going to put you onto a recording of the actual microphone itself. Alrighty, guys, so stay tuned for that. Okay, guys and girls, this is a sample of the built-in microphone on the Sades SA905 in white. Okay, once again, we're going to do a recap of the things I don't like about the headset and the things I like about the headset. So let's deal with the bad things first. So there is no mic mute, so you can't mute the microphone if you have to take a phone call during a gaming session or if someone walks in the room and you need to talk to them. The only option you've got is to actually go into your computer settings and mute the microphone. The volume control on the back of the ear cup only affects the headset itself. It doesn't actually interact with the computer sound card. So you can sometimes be left wondering why the headset's not working even when the volume's up. The elastic band or the elastic strap that fits on the top of this headset gives them a kind of a loose feel. So if you've got a small head, they may not be for you. The other thing is that the headset can distort if you crank the vibration up to strong and then introduce loud volume. When I say loud volume, that brings me on to the other bad thing about this headset. They're not as loud as what I hoped they would be. They're actually quite quiet, which I find pretty disappointing considering this is a USB powered headset. Most of the USB powered headsets I've tested before have actually been pretty good. They've been rather loud. This set, not so good. The other downside is that it's actually a non-braided cable. It feels like it's a plastic coated cable. So even though it could help its anti-tangle properties, it's kind of a bit of a letdown because it looks braided, but it's not. Okay, so quickly, once again, the bad things, no mic mute, the volume control only affects the headset itself. It's a loose-fitting headset, can distort with strong vibration on, and it's a non-braided cable, and yeah, they're not as loud as what I thought they could be. The good things about this headset, even though they are loose fitting, they are rather comfy. Even though the sound isn't loud, they do sound pretty good. They're not overly bright, they've got a pretty good mid-range. The bass, yeah, might not be as strong as some bass heads would like, but with that vibration function, it does enhance it a little bit. The good thing is that vibration headset gives you three levels of adjustment. So if you don't like the strong, you can have it on weak. And if you don't like it at all, you can turn it off. The other thing is that little vibration switch, when you push and hold it in, can turn off the LEDs. Okay. You can also turn the LEDs back on. I like the fact that each ear cup has its own LED, but the bad thing I don't like about it is that they don't seem to show the same color at the same time. I think it's a 7-color LED. I haven't actually counted the colors yet, but it looks like there's about 7 colors in them. But anyway, guys, that sums up the Sades SA905 in white. Can I recommend this headset? Yeah, sure. Not a problem at all. As long as you're aware that they're pretty quiet, can distort at high volume with the vibration set on high, and it doesn't have a mic mute. Other than that, guys, great sounding headset. I could recommend this pretty much to anybody. Alrighty, guys, until next time, I will say bye for now.